It feels so strange that using Windows has become one of my daily activities when I'm using my Mac, from playing Windows games to working on Microsoft Excel. And I was just thinking that some of you might have the same interest as me, but the biggest reason that holds you back might be the price. So if you want to get Windows working on your Apple Silicon Mac for free, you found the right videos. Let's talk about it. Oh, wait a minute, I almost forgot. I'm doing the free giveaways for 5 free Parallel Desktop license. So stay until the end of the video to learn how to join. It's easier than you think. Let's go. Okay, there's many ways that you can run Windows applications on your Mac, and you might heard about translation layer like crossovers or Wine to play Windows games. But to actually immerse yourself in a full Windows environment, there are 3 virtual machines that support Apple Silicon Mac, and they are Parallels, UTM, and VMware. UTM and VMware are free of charge, leaving Parallels as the only paid virtual machines, but there's actually a reason behind it. So before we get into the installation step, let's go ahead to find out which virtual machines is best fit for your need. The first 3 options is UTM, which will be great for a basic virtual machine need, because UTM doesn't support GPU emulations. So if you open Windows applications that don't rely on GPUs, like text editing or web browsing, you will not have any problems. But it won't be capable of handling intensive tasks that require 3D accelerations like gaming, video editing, and 3D rendering. So you are the people who rely a lot on virtual machine to get your work done, you might want to check out VMware Fusion. It's also free, but it supports DX11 and 3D accelerations, which means tasks that require real-time renderings like gaming or graphic design can be able to run. You can install pretty much any Windows applications that you need. Apps like Microsoft Excel are running great, handling spreadsheet, calculations, and chart without any issue. Even with the larger files or multiple tasks, it's performed efficiently and stay reliable. But apps that need more power from the GPUs like AutoCAD and Premiere Pro still can run, but they either take too long to load like this AutoCAD project, or delay multiple times when I try to edit videos on Premiere Pro. And keep in mind that this is a very simple scenario. If I work with more effects or workload, it might crash right away. So talking about game, there's not too many games that compatible with this VMware Fusion, even though it support the DX11 titles. This Batman game is a great example. It's work, but we don't get such a fair FPS. It's only range from 25 to 30 FPS, which is half of the performance when compared to Parallels. Also, VMware doesn't support Bluetooth controller like Parallels, so you will have to connect it with USB or playing games with your keyboard and mouse. So if you just want to port some basic Windows application to your Mac, considering to stay with VMware Fusion, you don't need to upgrade. It's free, it's good. But if you're serious about working and also gaming in your spare time, considering to switch to Parallels, because when compared to the other two, Parallels has way more optimization in both working and gaming. Software like AutoCAD runs so smooth that I hardly notice it is operating within a virtual machine. The design loads so quickly and navigation feels seamless. Parallels also has a very interesting view mode named Coherence, which allows you to run Windows app on your Mac desktop just like a normal application. I really like this one because it keeps you focused on what you are working on without switching between macOS and Windows. Also, files, hard drive, and USB connection can be shared across your Mac and Parallels. Besides working, gaming is another major thing in Parallels. It can handle a variety of games, from casual ones like Batman to more demanding games like Battlefield 1 and GTA 5 with a decent FPS. Parallels does cost you money, I get it, but if you're watching this video, you are super lucky because I'm doing the free giveaway for 5 Parallels desktop license. It is the Christmas gift for you, and all you have to do is comment down below the answer to this question. What would you use Parallels desktop for? And after 2 weeks, I would do the random pick with your username and announce the winner in the next YouTube videos. So give it a try, it's very easy to win because I usually get only 5 comments under my new videos, So you get a really high chance to win this. And come back to the videos, I think now you know which virtual machines that best fit for your need. Let's go ahead to show you how to install these on your Mac. We'll begin with the first one, which is UTM. You can click on the first link from this video description, which will direct you to the UTM website. And you might notice that we have two options, download directly or buying from the App Store. These two versions are the same, but if you can, consider buying from the App Store to support the development team. Once you get the DMG file, double click to open it and drag it into the application folder to complete the installation. Now open UTM, click Continues, create a new virtual machine, and select Virtualize and Windows. On this dashboard, make sure that you check into Import Boot Image and click on Continue. Now you can see UTM requires a boot image to continue. So what you have to do is go back to my description again and follow the second link. It will direct you to this website to download the boot image. Now if you already wrote in this Windows Insider programs, click sign in. If you are not, go ahead to register a new account. Once you finish, you'll be directed to this download page. Now click on Windows 11 on ARM Insider Preview on your right hand side. Scroll down and select the dev version and click confirm. Continue to select your language and finally click on download now to get the boot image for the ARM64 device. Now if your file format is ISO, it means you have downloaded the wrong files. For that reason, the installation will not work. So make sure you follow every single step precisely. The download will take about 10 minutes and when you got the files, go back to the UTM dashboard. Select the boot image that you just downloaded and click continue to customize your virtual machine graphics profiles. Now this will depend on your Mac specs. What I normally do is dedicate half of my Mac specs to a virtual machine. For example, I'm using the base Mac Mini M4 with 10 core CPUs and 60 gig of memories. So I'm gonna allocate 6 gig for memories and 5 CPU cores. Now, if you want to share files between your Mac and these virtual machines, you will need to create a directory path, which you can create a new folder on your Mac. I've already created a shared UTM folder here, so I'm just going to select that. Click Continue and review your setting one more time on the summary page. Now click Save to start the Windows installation. So at this point of the installation, the virtual machine doesn't have access to the network driver yet. We'll need to pass that with a terminal code. So on your keyboard, I want you to press this combination, Function, Shift, and F10. This combination to open the terminal. And when the terminal show, type in this code, OOBE/bypass NRO, and hit Enter. The installer should be restarted now, and you can continue to follow to finish. Now the last step we are going to do is install the UTM guest tune. This is a set of tunes that enhance this virtual machine's performance. It will install necessary drivers and enable the network as well. So open the folders and go to the UTM drive. Double click to install the UTM guest tunes. Once it's finished, you will be able to change the resolutions and also have access to the internet connection. Moving on to VMware. This installation gets a little easier but still has some work to do. So click on the third link from the description to the VMware website and hit on Download Fusion or Workstation. Now fill in your information and register a new account. And when you finish, select software from the top left corners and select my download. Now scroll down a bit and select VMware Fusion 13. Now we are going to download the latest versions, which is always on the top. Click on that and select the download buttons over here. When you first create a new account, they will need an additional verification. So click yes and fill in your personal information and hit on submit. Now click to the download icon again and the file should be downloaded automatically. Now you have the files, open it up and double click to start the installation process. Agree on the term and conditions and select personal use option to continue. Now you can use VMware for not only Windows, but also for Linux or even a second macOS. This video is focused on Windows installation, so we're gonna click on Get Windows from Microsoft. Click Continues and hit on Download Windows. When the installation is complete, click on Continues and create your VM password. Continue again and create a new virtual disk. Before we finish this configuration, click on Customize Settings to change a few things. The first settings will be processor and memory. So this one is pretty similar to what I explained in the UTM configurations. I will dedicate half of my Mac spec for these virtual machines. Moving on to the display tab, make sure Accelerate 3D Graphic is selected and you can close this configuration. Now click on Windows Player to start the installation. Select your language, times and locations, US keyboard, install Windows 11, agree, and hit on Next. At this step, if you have Windows keys, you can type in or just simply select I don't have a product key. Click Next and select Windows 11 Pro. Accept the term, click Next, and finally click to install. It will take about 5 to 10 minutes to finish, and the next following step are just personalizing your Windows experience. And the final step after Windows is successfully installed is to install VMware Tunes. This will again install the necessary driver to optimize the Windows performance and enhance your overall experience. So in order to do so, click on Virtual Machines and select Install VMware Tunes. Now go to your folders and select the D drive. Double click on Setup, Next, Difficult, and Install. After this installation, the virtual machine will restart automatically. And from now, your window can run efficiently and you'll be able to change the resolution. So if you're still here, that means those configuration and installation give you a hard time, right? I really feel you, because to make this video, I have to do over and over again. It takes me really long time to preparation. So I think I deserve for a subscribe or at least a like, right? So now I'm gonna show you how to install Windows with Parallels. You'll be surprised by how easy it is. Basically, you don't have to do anything, because one of the best things when using Parallels is the automatic installation. It saves time and a lot of headache. So from the description, you can find the link to the Parallels website and select from one of the three editions over here. I recommend you to select the Pro editions, as it is the most valuable package both for work and games on Windows. They're offering 25% off now, so I think it is great time to buy. Or in case you want to try it out first, you can sign up for a 14-day free trial and then decide whether you want to buy it or not. Now, when you got the installation files, click on Install Parallels Desktop and accept to the agreements, then type in your password. Okay, so if you buy, you will have an activation key. Just put in here to activate or click to free for 14 days to start your free trial. Now click to install Windows to start the installation automatically. You can also choose to install the Parallels Toolbox for more tunes like record screen, making GIF. In my case, I don't really need it, so I'm just going to skip. Now sit back and relax, let the installation do the work for you. It will take about 10 minutes to get everything ready. You don't need to do any further customization from this step. Okay guys, thanks for watching. Please enjoy free Windows on your MacBook. It doesn't matter if it's UTM, VMware, or Parallels Desktop. As long as you can get your work done, you can get what you want, I'm happy for that. So let me know in the comment, what do you think? Which virtual machine you like? And do you have any question? I'm happy to help. And also don't forget to join the giveaway. And I'll see you in the next video. I've talked too much today. See you. Bye.